Emily Thornberry is out of the running to be the next Labour leader, having failed to get enough support from constituency Labour parties or any from affiliate organisations such as unions.
Well, I'm sure you all know by now, Emily Thornberry got kicked to the curb last night, failing to get enough nominations to continue in the Labour leadership race. So, this video is rather pointless. I am just here to gloat at her complete failure, which has literally made my week, considering what a vicious Ramoning trout she has been over the years. It's just desserts, in my opinion. A lot of the media are reporting on this today, so we will have a butchers at this BBC article and a Radio 4 interview with one of the shitweasel MPs who nominated Emily Thornberry, allowing her to get this far. And during the interview, shows Joe Swinson levels of delusion regarding Brexit. Now, this MP who is speaking on BBC Radio 4 turned out to be someone who actually backed Clive Lewis as her first choice, meaning the only person willing to stand up for this old battle axe on TV is someone who didn't even consider her first choice and only got her nomination because Clive Lewis donated his couple to her, giving her the opportunity to get utterly humiliated at this stage of the contest. Might be a sign there, Emily, your own party thinks you're an unelectable battle axe like we all do. I mean, an argument could be made that Joe Swinson would be a better choice than you, and that is saying something. At the midnight Friday deadline, the Shadow Foreign Secretary had 31 nominations from local constituency parties, too short of the 33 needed. She did not get any nominations from Labour Party affiliates, meaning not a single union, as you heard earlier, backed her in this contest, which is, as it says there, the other route onto the ballot paper. It leaves Sir Keir Starmer, Rebecca Long Bailey and Lisa Nandy in the running to succeed the Corbynated chicken. All three had qualified with the support of unions and affiliate group. Miss Thornberry tweeted that it was a shame to miss out on the rest of the race, but good luck to the three superb remaining candidates. Yes, good luck to them. You guarantee the Labour Party don't get elected for another 20 years. Emily Thornberry continues, I'll have a week of rest now, then it's back to the day job of holding this wretched Tory government to account on its foreign policy, and doing so with the same passion, tenacity and forensic skill I've shown for 4 years in that role, she added. Well, I'm sorry to say, you won't be holding anyone to account. The Labour Party lacks the ability to hold anything to account since they were kicked to the curb at the last election. You know, the worst defeat in 85 years, leaving you in a piss-poor position and the Tories running the country without having to worry about the nonsense we dealt with over the last few years. The Shadow Foreign Secretary had struggled for support throughout the contest. Yeah, no shit. She only scraped through the first round of nominations by Labour MPs and MEPs with 23 votes, one more than the 22 required after Clive Lewis dropped out and instructed his supporters to give her their backing. If memory serves, she was on about 18 before he did that. Labour MP for York Central, Rachel Maskill, one of the MPs to nominate Miss Thornberry, told the Today programme it has been a strange contest which had polarised support. Oh, that's not all she said. Enough of this article, let's actually listen to what Rachel Maskill had to say, because it's yet another car crash interview from a Labour MP.
One of the MPs who nominated her is Rachel Maskill, the Shadow Employment Rights Secretary, and she's in our York studio. Good morning.
Good morning.
You're the MP for York Central, and I want to ask you about flood defences and about the likely impact of Storm Dennis in just a moment. But first on Emily Thornberry, why do you think she didn't get through to the next round?
Because she's a cunt.
Well, five incredible people put themselves forward across the Labour Party, and all of them had different talents, different things to bring. But it's been a strange contest in the way that it's just polarised the support really between two of the main candidates there. But what I would say about Emily, she's an incredibly talented, strong woman, very experienced politician and a tireless campaigner. And she certainly has got a lot to offer our party
but
as we move forward.
That experience, including being someone with first-hand experience, prominent in taking on Boris Johnson because of her foreign affairs portfolio. She's been doing that in the House of Commons for some time. All the more striking that, you know, it's Lisa Nandy rather than Emily Thornberry who's the third candidate through.
Five incredible Ramoning fuck pigs is what Rachel meant to say at the start of that, I think. It's not really been strange, though. The Labour Momentum movement has backed Rebecca Wrong Daly. Most of the rest backed Keir Starmer, and the others went for Lisa Nandy, as they think she is a moderate. When we all found out just the other day her transgender plans to expel anyone from the party who disagrees with the lunacy we are seeing too much of these days. You might remember the woman's right group Lisa Nandy labelled as a hate group because, shockingly enough, they think women are women. You know, that outlandish thought. This leadership contest shows the Labour Party is completely batshit crazy. But not crazy enough, it would seem, to let Emily the Ramonin fuckpig Thornbury stand a chance of being the Labour leader and dragging it down further than the Corbynated chicken or the other candidates ever could. I mean, it's common knowledge she's not exactly well liked by the public, and now she should know she is not liked by the Labour Party either. I absolutely fucking love it. But let's move on. The stupidity has not finished yet.
Would you like her to stay in her foreign affairs, shadow foreign secretary role, whoever the next Labour leader is?
Absolutely. I think Emily has got so much to give us for the future. And there is so much to do on the international stage, particularly setting out a human rights agenda in the way that we interact with the world, but also looking at issues around trade and workers' rights within that. So I think she has got so much more to give.
Has this woman lost the plot, or is it just me? Emily should stay on to set the agenda for the UK in the future. She is the shadow foreign secretary, not the actual foreign sec. She don't set the agenda for shit. We are not in the 2017 parliament anymore, sweet cheeks. Thornbury, like all shadow ministers, are just passengers along for the ride in this situation. They can't do shit except piss and whine like babies because Boris Johnson has a majority. She won't be setting out human rights or anything else. And I can definitely promise you Dominic Cummings and Boris Johnson are not going to let this trout have a single say on anything related to Brexit or the trade deals. That is a job for government. You know, the winners. The losers get to watch and cry them sweet Ramona tears we will be drinking for many years to come. This Labour MP is clearly living in a fantasy land. Now, let's check out the final clip I've taken from this interview before I end the video.
I'm going to be supporting Keir Starmer. I believe that he has set out a very clear position of leadership, and leadership is a very special quality that few hold, and therefore what we need to ensure is that somebody who's going to shape our relationship with Europe in the future, who is going to shape those trade deals. And I think what Keir demonstrated throughout the process of Brexit, which obviously is a painful experience for everybody across the country, is that he set out the red lines. He provided the leadership which the government had to jump to. And when you're in opposition, you want to lead from opposition, and we need to hold Boris Johnson to account.
He was the architect of a position that was not at all popular with the voters. And I wonder if that was part of the reason why you didn't support him in the first place, because you first supported Clive Lewis and then you supported Emily Thornbury.
So she is going to support Sir Keir Starmer, who she thinks is the best person to shape the Brexit trade deals in the future. Wake up, for fuck's sake. You are not going to be in a position to negotiate anything for more than a decade, maybe two. Keir Starmer is not going to change the fortunes of the Labour Party. And for her to claim his position on Brexit makes him the best choice is Joe Swinson levels of delusion, I think you would agree. And to be honest, the BBC host stands just as baffled as I am by that comical statement. As usual though, the Labour MP comes out with some complete bullshit that is not checked by the shitweasel BBC host. I would love to know where this deluded spunk trumpet heard that the whole country thinks the Brexit situation is painful. We are all fairly cheery about it now on this side of the argument, because guess what? We're off, we won, end of story. There is no pain now for us because democracy has won, and in the process, we kept socialist spunk trumpets like you out of government, saving not only the democratic choice this country made, but also saving the country as a whole from the incompetent anti-British shitweasel known as the Corbynated chicken. Followed, of course, by deluded bints like this loony. Her delusions are summed up by the end of that clip, though, thinking Sir Keir Starmer actually forced anything to happen regarding Brexit. The Ramona's attempts to stop Brexit, led by the likes of Starmer and Hillary Benn, got kicked to the curb in December, when the people of this country voted to get Brexit done, remember? To think he is going to bring back former Labour voters who you lot betrayed really is new levels of Joe Swinson's fantasy politics. Maybe that's why we ain't heard from the former Lib Dem leader recently. She is now the secret advisor to the Labour Party, since they are getting more and more deluded by the day, it would seem. Like I said earlier, long may it continue. But on that note, guys, I am going to end the video there. Now, before I go, I've started doing live streams and uploading gaming content on my second channel. If you would like to come and join me for a live stream to chat in real time, have an interest in gaming related content on YouTube, or just want to follow me over there because you are a legend, the link will be down in the video description below and as a pinned comment. I hope to see you all there. Now, as always, before I go, I want to thank our PayPal, Patreon, Subscribestar and YouTube members for supporting the channel, along with everyone who watches my videos. Remember to let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. Leave a like, subscribe with the notification bell, and share this video as it helps the channel a lot. And I will see you all in the next one.